Hello, welcome you all on Shalini e-learning environment and we. I am Dr. Shalini Gupta. In this video, I will be discussing about environment philosophy with respect to various religions and culture practice in our country for environment conservation. So environment philosophy is related to environmental ethics, or we can say our moral duty towards environment protection. As we all know that India has diverse religion like Hindus, Christianity, Islam, Jainism and the other cultures, and each religion of and their cultural practices is somehow related to protection of our environment. So begin with our first slide. Environment and Hinduism. In Hindus, nature is considered as body of God. I mean, whatever elements are present in our natural environment is itself considered or exist as God. Either it is belong to a small living organism or creature, to any non-living factors like river, lake, pond, air, soil, plants, etc. Environment protection in Vedas. Rig Veda clearly mention about 5 basic elements: earth, water, air, fire, space, which provide basis of our life. Or we can say these 5 elements are our life support system, and so it is the duty of a man to conserve these elements. Yajurveda talked about to maintain care and peace among all the abiotic, non-living, biotic, living component of earth. Atharveda consider earth to be mother, and it shows the direct close relationship between man and mother earth, as we as offspring of her, and we should take care of each and every creature exist on planet earth. Ved commands the knowledge to keep the environment free from all the impurities, which can be done by way of yagnas, sacrificial fires, by the way of havans, and through this a chemical vapor is generated or emitted through the havans, which is helpful in neutralizing the pollutant present into the atmosphere. Protection in Purans. There are 18 Purans, and some of them are listed in the here in the slide. Narsingh Puran symbolizes tree as God himself. Vara Puran advocate and promote the regular plantation, which symbolizes life, living life peacefully and paradise on earth. Matasya Puran regard planting a single tree is equivalent to leaving a progeny of 10 sons. It will be passed on to 10 generation. Vishnu Puran, God is pleased with a person who does not harm non-speaking living creature. Or Padma Puran and Kama Puran mention all the sacred tree like Bel, Har, Neem as a board of God and not to be cut. Durga Saptasati says, as long as these elements will exist, the natural element will exist, the human race will also survive. Charak Samhita says the destruction of vegetation will cause worsen the climatic condition like drought, and Padma Puran totally condemn and killing, cattle killing in sacrifice, and this action will lead to be found to be guilty. And Bhagavad Gita consider nature as one entity, or we can say it is a one unit consisting of two components, which is having two components, which is pur and upper. And pur, which is the meaning of consciousness, or we can say in the terms of environment, it is the biotic component, and upper is the abiotic component or unconscious part. So Gita considered the nature as the essence of human culture. So if we kept nature apart from human survival, it will be equal to body without soul. Environment and Buddhism. This religion is about love, compassion, non-violence, and they pay respect for forests, rivers, sun, moon. They follow path of ahimsa and non-violence. Dalai Lama once said about the interdependence of all the living and non-living component on each other. If there is a river in any geographical area, it will be surely indirectly related to the mountains and its geographical relation and the flora and fauna of that area. So environment Jainism rely on the principle of environment is not only for the one element, it should be enjoyed by every creature peacefully and follow the path of non-violence. Jain attain environment harmony by spirituality, and which is acquired by right belief, right conduct and right knowledge. Environment and Sikhism. Sikh believe a universe created by Almighty God, a balance and stability between all these natural elements is essential. The history of Guru contains stories of a special relationship with the natural environment, and it teaches survival of man and nature is closely linked to each other. Now, environment and Islam. The Quran, a holy book of Islam religion, consists message about balance between nature's law and unity, harmony, and consider human as a trustee responsible for maintaining the unity of his creation, that is natural flora and fauna. Environment is not the service only for the present generation, it is a gift of God for all the generation, and we should know our limits. Now, environment and Christianity. Holy book Bible also mentioned the triadic relationship between God, nature and man. So God is above all the elements. He created all this natural element exist on this planet, and we should share this common heritage and bond with the plants, animal and other elements. So Pope John in 1972 in the first environment conference said that environment resources are for everyone. So it should be enjoyed peacefully by the every creature. Environment and Indian culture, how these things are interrelated to each other. So India is a land of rituals and cultural heritage which is being transferred to one generation to next generation for the sustenance of life on this planet Earth. So some common practices are listed here, like knowledge and application of herbs, Ayurveda and Indian homes, and traditional cuisines on a special occasion, mostly depending upon the geographical location and season. And in Hindu religion, practice of yag, havan and many other temple rituals which play a significant role in environmental protection. And khichdi trees, which is ecologically important in Rajasthan, and its importance in water retention. Rainwater harvesting system in India, Johars in Rajasthan, Stepwell in Gujarat, Jabo in Nagaland, tank system for water conservation in the southern part of the country like Tamil Nadu, and utilization of food waste, energy saving technique for cooking in Indian homes, like use of sun drying or for the production of some food items like papad, pickles and many other items, and use of hand grinding machine rather than using mixer grinders, and some other techniques also which are energy saving. And Indian diet is primarily plant based. We most of the Indians are vegetarians, so we have very low carbon footprint in compared to the other foreign countries, and sustainable consumption values. Conclusion of the above content. If we want a healthy environment, so we have to follow our ancient cultural practices as they were before, and we need to shift mind back to our value system. So that's all for this discussion. If you find this video informative, so please like and subscribe this channel. Thank you.